The people, the lights, the sounds, school can be an overwhelming experience. But repeatedly lining up your pencils in order of color and length might help. Or what about drumming your fingers to a steady beat? Or spinning around in circles, arms outstretched to the world? These kinds of behaviors all fall under the description of restricted and repetitive behaviors. They appear from a young age in people with autism and are one of the condition's core features, alongside problems with social communication. Typically, restricted and repetitive behaviors fall into two categories. Low-order behaviors are motor and sensory in nature and can include hand flapping, rocking back and forth, spinning, playing persistently with objects, and uttering repeated sounds. Some people describe these behaviors as stimming. High-order behaviors are more cognitive and take the form of intensely focused interests, ritualistic habits, and an insistence on sameness and routine. There's scant research exploring these behaviors, but we do know that repetitive movements occur as part of regular development in all young children. Because they persist beyond childhood in those with autism, disruptions in typical development could be involved. Emerging research also shows that when autistic people engage in restricted and repetitive behaviors, their brains show greater activity in the reward circuits, just as eating cake or winning an award might do. That might help explain why many people on the spectrum engage in them regularly. As this research progresses, clinicians and caregivers continue to question how, and if, they should intervene to stop or control repetitive behaviors. Historically, these behaviors were viewed as having no inherent value, and it was thought best to suppress them. That may still be the case when they are harmful, like with repetitive headbanging. But there has been a dramatic change in thinking when it comes to stimming. Many experts now believe that some repetitive behaviors are coping mechanisms, and as such deserve more thoughtful management. In support of that idea, many autistic people describe their repetitive behaviors as a source of focus or calm when they feel overwhelmed or need to manage anxiety. They may need to stim less if they have access to earplugs and sunglasses to buffer against sensory overload, or a new routine to create a greater sense of structure. Some autistic people say they simply enjoy engaging in repetitive behaviors, much like a hobby. Others say they are a way of communicating and expressing emotions. Taking these behaviors away would strip them of these benefits and might cause frustration and withdrawal. Caregivers might enable an autistic relative to perform an activity of interest, like examining train schedules, in a safe space, but establish gentle boundaries, like limiting the amount of time spent on it. Striking a balance between adaptation and acceptance can lead to great things, including new experiences, interests, and talents.